In this video, we're going to take a look at our Sherline collet.com, where our website is. It's going to be our collet system for the Sherline headstocks. Now, that'll work either for the lathe or that'll work for the mill too. And the reason that we developed these, now you can ignore this, we'll reset this and show you the run out in just a moment. But the reason that we developed this is because we were making supercharger parts and they needed to be really, really accurate. They had to be really quite round, so they had to be very concentric. Otherwise, they create wobbles, anything that turns at 100,000 RPM plus, and that creates problems. So we were having difficulty because the only thing that we could get for a collet system through Sherline was these just like microscopic collets that didn't have any, you couldn't run anything, there's no through hole in it, you couldn't really do much with it, and the stock sizes were so small, they weren't useful for us. And we really couldn't use their jaw chucks because the jaw chucks, we just couldn't get them dialed in accurately. And even if you had independent jaws on it, it just takes so much time that we had to develop our own system. So what we ended up doing is custom ground spindles. And this particular one is our ER-32. Now, we have these in ER-40, ER-32, 25, 20, 16, and 11. And these are all custom ground, hardened, and balanced out. So what you'd get in a normal kit, okay, if you just get a kit that's our bare bones basic kit, you want to use your own headstock, you're going to get the spindle, you're going to get the spindle nut, you're going to get the spanner for tightening it, and you'll get the bearings. And you'll have to press all that in yourself. Now, what I would personally recommend to you, though, is that you get one from us that is preloaded. And there's a couple reasons for that. Number one is there's no risk of you screwing up the bearings, basically, trying to press the thing in, because these are all extremely tight fits. So when they leave us in our location, they're already preset and pressed in correctly. The other thing is, it's always nice if you think that you might use their chuck setup or, you know, some other setup, the faceplate or something like that, that Sherline offers as a standard, it's nice to keep the standard headstock and that spindle already attached. So what you'd have to do is you'd detach the motor piece off from it, you'd put, you know, this one back on or vice versa, however you want to do it. But if you're looking for really the ultimate in accuracy and work holding, this really is, in our estimation, it when it comes to the Sherline system, is using larger collets. And if you're looking for holding larger stock and being able to hold it in a collet with a, you know, a through hole, this will also do it. It's just super accurate, and, you know, compared to the collet system that Sherline has, like I say, and their jaw chucks, this is head and shoulders above. So let's go ahead and take a look at, I'm going to zero this out. It's going to measure down in the 10,000s. And we'll take a look at what runout is going to be in this. And that is on there. That is running on there. And this particular one, it's into the 100,000s. It's extremely accurate. Now, when we send these out, the accuracy that's our minimum is we like to see 4/10,000s or less. But oftentimes, you know, this is the result. So we just like to, you know, deliver better than what's advertised, kind of thing. Now, if you look at this, by the time you put this nut on here, okay, just so you know this ahead of time, especially if you have the really small Sherline lathe, and this can be used on either the mill or the lathe, but this will eat up, if it's on a lathe, it's going to eat up, you know, some of your x-axis, and, it's going to eat up some of your z-axis, and it's going to eat up some of your z-axis in a mill too. Now, how much of that is from right here where it starts to the end where the nut would be screwed down there, tightened down? You're looking at about 55 millimeters, so it's a little over 2 inches, okay? And once you get it, what you're going to get is, and I'll have to show this to you, I'm gonna turn the camera off for a second so I can get this out and show it to you. I'll show you exactly how it comes to you. What you're going to get when you receive this, if you get the very basic kit, okay, which is the spindle, the nut, and the bearings that you have to press all this in yourself, that's a very basic kit. If you want the preloaded headstock, which is what I recommend you do, this is exactly how you'd receive it. And the there is a through hole in here, and if you need to extend it, we do have threads in the back of there, okay? Now, if you need a larger through hole, of course, if you drill this out or you order it from us drilled out, then you're not going to have these threads, because you, if you want to put some additional encoder or something on the back, if you have some custom setup. Now, it also can be loaded in with their industrial. This is the industrial size one, and you can see the difference between the two. If you're going to do a custom setup, some kind of custom router or mill, you might want to go with the industrial one. It's a heavier duty one. But for those who are just replacing their headstock on their lathe or the mill and want really the ultimate in accuracy, this is it. Now, we do offer some different ranges. We offer one shaft size that's actually thicker than this if you need a larger through hole in it. And also, if you get the thicker shaft one, we can also put little different bearings here. If you need high speed, now these are rated to 10,000 RPM, the bearings are in here. But if you're going to run this continuous duty, okay, and you want ultimate in precision, and you want to run at 10,000 RPM, all the way up to 15,000 RPM, then you'll want to get our angular contact bearings in these. Now, that does jump the price, obviously, but angular contact bearings really are the ultimate when it comes to the bearings for your headstock. So there you have it. There's a little overview of our headstock using, this one's the ER-32, but our ER conversion kits if you want to run collets in there, get the ultimate in work holding and precision. Go to sherlinecollet.com and there's more information on there. And we, at this point, we take, you know, PayPal and check. And these, it's just so you know too, at this point, we do all these as custom orders as they come in. We get these ground for us for now. So the lead time as it is right now, just know ahead of time, that's going to be 3 to 4 weeks. So 3 to 4 weeks, unless there's some holiday or some unforeseen occurrence. And I'm just telling you now, if you're in, anytime you're in the manufacturing world, you know, those things can happen, you know, but 3 to 4 weeks is pretty much your standard delivery time on these. So once again, go to sherlinecollet.com and check them out. They're a really great piece if you're looking for the ultimate in precision.